So this is a 12 by 16 canvas. And I just finished up a pour and I've got some things drying and I wanted to do one more. And I want to do the ocean colors. I just love that combination. So I think I'm going to use my teal mint and sea breeze, which are these here. Got my white, ultra blue deep, which is this one, and I might add a little purple. Wet paper towel here. Maybe I'll do the peacock teal as well. This one here, and then it's ultra blue deep is in it, and some evergreen to make it deeper. This is the oxyacene purple here, titanium white. This is my white bottle, and I always keep a big jug of it. I'm going to add some more to my squeeze bottle. I always keep this around to add to my squeeze bottle or even to base coat a canvas if I'm starting with the white canvas, that kind of thing. I hear thunder. So these are all 1:1 mixed with the DecoArt pouring medium. And they don't need extra water because they're fluid enough in the bottles to not need the water added. My gloves on to try to save my hands a little bit. I really want to swipe with like the deep blue. So I'm just trying to figure out how I want to do this. I'm going to try just something different today. Decide if I want to do the white or not, or blue. I guess I'll just go with white, traditional white. This ultra blue deep. I'm not even putting it in the same order, really. This is the sea breeze. And this is the bluegrass. Green. I knew I'd be running out of it. That's teal mint. That's teal mint. I'm sorry, I've been calling it bluegrass. I'm going to mix up some more real quick. So you take your paint. This is not quite a full bottle, but it's almost a 2 ounce bottle. So I've probably got around an ounce of paint in here. I add the same amount of pouring medium. You just stir it up and it's pretty much ready to go. Now everything in my squeeze bottles has silicone in it. So I'm gonna add a drop of silicone, a spot on treadmill lubricant. And I stir it and I shake it because I like smaller cells. So then you add it to your bottle. And this bottle is maybe 1 ounce to 2 ounces. But you want to make sure it pours off your stick in a steady stream. Which it does, it's pretty perfect. So I'm going to make a little point to get it into this bottle. So what I can do is just use it straight out of the cup. So now I have a whole bottle of it again. Teal mint, and I think I'm going to add sour apple. It's in the squeeze bottle too, because I'm kind of feeling these and you really even don't, I don't think you need this much paint on your canvas, but I'm just trying to kind of keep from having any gaps when I swipe. So some people do like full coverage where there's no canvas showing, and I don't think you really have to do that. I am trying to make sure I have it stuff along the edges so it will pour over on the sides, because I like to have my sides fill in any gaps that are kind of noticeably bigger.
The other thing you can do,
I realized that one of my lights was on, is you can move it around a little bit. And that'll help blend some of the paint together too, but I'm not even gonna really. This is Vivid Violet. Now I wanna stick a little Vivid Violet in just here and there. So my plan is to swipe with white, but you know, this would be really pretty swiped with black too. I'm gonna go ahead and swipe it with white. Here's my wet paper towel. It's not quite wide enough, so I've got three, you know how they tear in three parts? I've got a three-part piece here. And I'm gonna lay it in the white and let it rest in the white paint totally. And I can go back up here and add somewhere. It went down to the canvas area. So I'm gonna use my heat gun. I'm just gonna let it sit for a few minutes. Got my canvas in the frame. I didn't realize it was off the frame. Sorry about that. So I'm going to let this continue to just do its thing by itself without the heat gun and see if anything else pops up in this area. And if not, that might be a pretty area to do some painted flowers or something kind of cool. So I'm going to let this continue to sit. And while I wait, I can't help but want to do a swipe with these colors that I love so much. So I'm going to use the Teal Mint. Sour Apple. Some white in. Well, let's see. I guess I'll do the ultra blue deep. Put in a little bit of the bright blue. That's the bright blue. And I'm gonna swipe with white. And I'm gonna leave it. This is the extra piece of paper I have. I'm going to put it on the piece of paper so that what comes off stays on this piece of paper. So I've got light. This is the right width for the photo paper. Just pretty, pretty colors together. I'm trying to decide. I want to scrape it one more time. Like I didn't get it. I didn't scrape it hard enough. So that's prettier. This is just basically parchment paper, which, like when I ship paintings, I always put parchment paper around my painted surface so that nothing that's like paper is going to stick to it, or plastic. So parchment paper is good for covering your canvases after they're sealed and been dry for quite a while. Parchment paper is wonderful, so I always keep parchment paper around. So there's that with the, I love it with the sour apple and the blues and the turquoisey colors of the teal mint. So some of these will make pretty little cells for some jewelry. I think what I'm going to do is let this stay the way it is, because it kind of feels, you know, gardeny. And I'm going to go up in the white and play. It's kind of like what I did with that other swipe where I swiped with black and then I did the lotus looking flowers at the bottom. I'm going to do the opposite kind of thing. I'm going to put the flowers up here as if they're growing up at the top, and this is the top I'm going to leave white. So I'm going to get my straw. And that's going to go out the camera, but you know what that looks like, so I'm not worried about that. So I'm going to try this out first. Ooh, I like that because it has some of the color underneath. Kind of like that. Scoot it up a little bit. So now I want to come back with the deep peacock teal that I made. And the sour apple. I'm going to put a little bit of a highlight of that bright green. This is carousel pink. Which is this bright pink here. I don't want to overtake the deeper pink, so I'm gonna put some of it back on there. I have not had a chance to go get a piece of tubing, which people suggested. So, I like that. Try to break up some of the white down here for a little bit. So you can kind of control a little bit. Like if you blow into it too much, you can kind of bring the color back down. If you blow this way or blow that way, you know. The cool part about it is that they're not real flowers, but they have that abstract feel of being like a flower. That's the really cool part about it. You know, flowers are. And real, if you paint it realistically, they take some time to paint. And this is fun, just being able to blow paint and make it look like an abstract flower. That's the really cool part about this. And I love the way the other colors popped up in the petals, which makes it even kind of more interesting. I was trying to make points, but I don't really like the points now. See, kind of up close there. And then zoom out and there's the painting. And I'm sure it will change as it dries. Like I'm trying to keep that the white from drifting into that magenta color, if I can help it. So I'm trying to keep a little bit of a flower shape. That's kind of neat, though. I like it. It's playful, colorful, fun, unexpected. I didn't plan on doing that. It's like when you do your painting, you just kind of go with the flow, and if you feel like something's going to look good, try it. That's the whole point of doing this, is doing something you love and experimenting to see what happens. Breaking up that surface of the white a little bit so it's not so strong, but I like the solid white, and that will probably change as it dries. So I'm gonna leave that be, call it done. I'm gonna remember to add the colors to my list, because I always put the colors below, so that if you want to try something similar, you'll have the color references of the deco art paints. So I hope you liked it. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I'm gonna bring the camera down and let you look up close too. So here is the bottom of the canvas. And I don't know if there's enough light to see, but that I let it drip over the edges and come down on the ends. So on the other end, it's gonna be white because the top of the canvas is white. And then you come up, and there's the flowers. But where's my green button? Put my finger on it. They're abstract-looking flowers, but they're kind of really cool the way the cells popped up as I blew on the vivid violet. So that made the flower look. I see one area. I don't like the pink going through the petal there. Weird like that. But I mean, the flowers are just real fun. That one especially has all of the colors in it. It's just really, they're really cool looking. And then they just kind of have them fade into the rest of the painting. The stems are a little wobbly, but that's okay. But that is really fun. And then if I zoom in, the color separation is not like super strong. Right here you get a pop of that sour apple. But like the magenta, let me find some magenta for you. It looks different on the camera than it does in real life. So there's a little bit. It's got some neat little cells going on. Little tiny peacock cells. With all kinds of little tiny cells inside of cells. And that's from having the paint in the squeeze bottles with the silicone mixed in. And I shake them. So, and the white does not have silicone, so that's why the white separates larger, but that's why you have all these little tiny cells, is because it is shaken in the bottles. Now, if I had done like strips, bands of color, you would have had more definition in the colors, but because I kind of zigzagged it, mixed all the colors together, then you have all the colors mixing like this. But this is like really cool right here on the side. These little cells on the side, they're blues and greens and that sour apple and kind of psychedelic looking up through there. Kind of cool. So there they are, all the deco art stuff. And I like deco art because it's not the thicker artist grade tube paint, and you mix it with the pouring medium 1:1, and it's a nice ratio that you don't have to really fool with adding water to and stuff like that. It's just straight out paint and pouring medium. And then you add the silicone if you want the cells, and then you get to play like this, which I love doing. I mean, I could do this over and over again because I love color and I love just experimenting. So I appreciate you watching. Thank you.